Ladies and gentlemen, that was SMU's Page One and Nicholas Chu presenting Elegies for Two Pianos, also by Francis Poelli.
And the elegy that we just heard was simply superb.
Yes, Shell, it was touching in its simplicity, yet it conveys a tone of hope and vaccination.
It seems that we had quite a variety of pieces ranging from dance to music from the Romantic era.
Indeed. The next piece that we will be listening to is an adaptation of an orchestral work.
That's amazing. What is it called?
It's actually one of my favorite works. It was built on the characteristics of two types of Spanish dances and is vivid in its vitality. Thereafter, we will also have a performance of Suite for Two Pianos, founded upon old Irish melodies, Opus 104, Number 1, by Amy Beach, performed by Clarencia Lynn and Tabitha Gunn.
But for now, without further ado, let us put our hands together for España, by Emmanuel Chabrier, presented by Stephanie Liu and Shuli Lu from NUS.
Ladies and gentlemen, round of applause!
Thank you.
some amazing playing. Wasn't it, Cheryl?
Yes, it was, Dejong. The sudden contrast in moods from such a lively piece to a darker piece really kept me on the edge of my seat.
Music can indeed express itself in a manner no words can.
What an evening it has been. How many pieces are we left with?
I'm afraid all good things will eventually come to an end. But before we round off the night, we still have two pairs of musicians.
That's right. For the next few minutes, we'll be listening to a lovely piece titled Russian Round Dance, Opus 58, No. 1, composed by Nikolai Mechner.
After which, we'll be welcoming our last pair, Clarice Teo and Joanne Kwan from MUS, with Suite No. 2 for two pianos, Opus 17, Movement 4, Tarantella, by the legendary Sergei Rachmaninoff.
But for now, let's put our hands together for Alvin Wong and Edwin Peng.